We enjoy the light from the sun during the day and then the comforting glow of the moon at night. But the light coming from the moon is an illusion.
As you know, you're actually seeing the reflected light from the sun bouncing off the moon, which acts like a mirror. A really terrible mirror.
If you were on the surface of the moon, the color would be very similar to my shirt. It's actually mostly lava. The moon is entirely made of igneous rock. And so this is a lot like what it would be like if you were on a volcano or in a volcanic field here on Earth. The rock would be very dark. It's not new rock by any means. I mean, the moon would have mostly solidified a little over 4 billion years ago. The large, flat, darker areas, those are thought to be between 3 and 3.5 billion years old. The only thing that's kind of new is if you get a meteorite impact, and this will change the structure of the rock nearby. When you were looking at brighter spots on the moon, those are places that have been hit recently, and they haven't had time to undergo all of the erosion due to micrometeorites and the radiation from just sitting out in space without any atmospheric protection for billions of years.
Because of its dark color and bumpy surface, it only reflects about 12% of the light that hits it. Additionally, the amount of light we get from the moon depends on the point of its orbit. During its first and last quarters, the moon is half illuminated, but it's only 8% as bright when it's full. Just imagine the surface when it's only partly illuminated. When the sun is at a steep angle, the mountains cast long shadows. This makes the lunar surface much darker than when it's directly illuminated.
One of the reasons that the moon is so much brighter than its full is if you look at how light reflects off of something. If you get something at kind of a shallow angle, then you're not getting quite as much light reflected off of. If that's a surface that's light is hitting it and bouncing right back at you, it's going to be much brighter. So that's one of the reasons. The other reason is just when it's full, the maximum amount of area to reflect light from the sun back onto the Earth is available. So one is the angle's a much more direct reflection, and two, you just have more area than you would at any other phase of the moon.
During the full moon, it's so bright that it obscures fainter objects in the night sky. Many astronomers put their telescopes away during this phase and wait for it to go away. When the moon is highly illuminated, it reflects so much light, we can even see it during the day.
The moon follows an elliptical orbit around the Earth, changing its distance and brightness quite a bit.
The moon gets about 5% closer and 5% farther away as it goes around the Earth. The point at which it gets closest to the Earth, called perigee, doesn't sit in one place in space. It actually precesses around the moon. And so you get times where full moon occurs at perigee. And so at that point, the moon is about 5% closer than it is on average. And being a little bit closer makes it a little bit bigger and a little bit brighter.
When it's at its closest point and it's full, this is known as a supermoon.
This moon can be 20% brighter than normal. You've probably experienced how the moon can cast shadows. In fact, there are three objects in the sky that can cast shadows. The sun, of course, the moon,
and Venus. Venus is the next brightest object in the sky after the moon. It reflects 65% of the sunlight that hits it. Every few months, Venus reaches its brightest time. That's when you can see your shadow. On a night with no moon, head far away from city lights. Let your eyes adjust and watch as your hand casts a shadow on a white piece of paper, illuminated only by Venus. One last thought on reflected light. We talked about how bad a mirror the moon is, reflecting only 12% of the light that hits it. That's nothing. Saturn's moon Enceladus, on the other hand, reflects about 99% of the light that falls on it. If astronauts ever get the chance to walk on the surface of Enceladus, it'll feel like freshly fallen snow.
Thanks for watching. Now make sure you click subscribe on our YouTube channel here. And maybe you still got some questions about space and astronomy, like this one or that one. And if you don't see what you're looking for, then send me an email at info@universetoday.com.
Supermoon!